안녕하세요. 아이고, 더워라. Hello, anybody there? And also, if you guys can hear me, let me know if voice is okay, sound is okay. Should I say more louder? 안녕하세요. 아무도 없나요? No one is there? 안녕. 아무도 없어? 안녕하세요. 헬로 가이즈. 뭐라고? Is there something wrong? 안녕하세요. 왔다 왔다. 오예. 잠깐만. 타이머를 그러면 I set the timer. 안녕. 에드먼드 씨. 오, 다들 왔네. 큐티 노들 씨 안녕하세요. 아. 이게 한 시간이 1, 2분 정도 기다려야 되는구나. I really worry about no one comes today. 안녕하세요. 아이고. 오늘 우리 엄청 바쁠 거예요. Today is the first day of our challenge. So I haven't decided to set the date, set the time for Sunday. 안녕. 근데 아마도 10시? Same time, tomorrow? 안녕하세요, 피노도 오고, 에즈임씨도 안녕하세요. So, guys, I don't know if you guys know about this. We have a 30 days Korean challenge. 어디 때? So, today is the first day. 30 days. Korean. So I'm going to 안녕 나무. 안녕 줄레야 씨. So I'm going to stream every day 1 hour a day. And 안녕 시루티. 어 진짜. I was really worried about it because when I start streaming, no one comes. So is there something wrong or 아무도 오늘 안 올려나? 걱정했어요. 케이티 씨도 안녕하세요. 오랜만이에요. Long time no see. 스니키 베어 씨도 안녕하세요. So guys, you guys really need to let me know if the sound is okay. 안녕 사치 씨. So 30 day Korean challenge. 안녕 아미고 가명 씨. 오디오 is perfect. 예. 근데 아, 고맙습니다, 여러분. Okay, so let's do it together. Today is first day of 30 days Korean challenge. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, I'm going to do the stream 5 p.m. in European Central Summertime, and Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday. Same time. Today. 그래서 매일 할 거예요. And also the content is we are going to learn idiom, proverbs, topic word, topic basic and intermediate topic word. You guys know about topic? 안녕. 수거. Idiom is 수거, not 속어. 그리고 유행어. We are also going to learn Korean slang. 그리고 last, we are going to learn 사자성어. When we learn 사자성어, I'm going to give you a little bit of 한자. So it's more like focus the word. So let's do it. I hope to see you guys every day. I'm also going to make some kind of 출석부. So you can actually check. If you come to the streaming, just check. 안녕 네이토 씨, 반가워요. 이카루 씨도 안녕하세요. So since we only have 1 hour, 가자, 가자. Oh yay, 갑시다. And guys, please let me know if it's too difficult or if you don't understand or if I like speak too fast like a rapper. 오, 고맙습니다, 이카로스 씨. Please, please let me know, okay? 약속해요. Please. 약속, promise. Pinky promise. 안녕하세요, 지호 씨. 다들 약속했다? 오케이, 좋아. 시작. 그리고 also remind me, save my note before I delete it. 약속해요. 파이팅! 아자 아자 할수 있다. We can do it. 할수 있다. So first, start with a quiz. 수거. 아, 수거라고 안 할게요. Wanna say 관용어, which is idiom. Idiom is the word or expression has a totally another meaning. So, for example, you guys need to guess. 마음이 So, 마음 is 마음. 마음 can be heart or mind. 마음이 굴뚝. Have you heard about word 굴뚝? 굴뚝은 뭔지 몰라요? Good. So you learn the word today, 굴뚝. I'm gonna draw for you. So this is the house, 집이에요. 집에. 띠띠띠, 띠띠띠. This is 굴뚝. 굴뚝이 뭐예요, 여러분? 침니! 네! 굴뚝! 뚝! 발음 좀 어려울 거예요. 굴뚝! 굴뚝. So, 침니. 스펠링 모르는데? 침니. 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 같다 is 영어로는 like, 그러니까 like라고 하면 안 되겠구나. Same. So my mind is like chimney. If I translate 마음이 굴뚝 같다. Once mind is like chimney. Can you guys guess the meaning of this? Quiz. I love quiz with the Korean idiom because you guys are so creative. So whenever I saw the answer, 너무 재밌어요. It's so fun. 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 무슨 뜻일까요? Home is the where the heart is. Good guess, but 아니에요. 'Being in love', 오, 아니에요? 'With the, your head in the cloud', 'Burning with love', 'You're thinking so hard that your head is smoking'. have the same mind thought. Guys, thinking about 굴뚝. What is 굴뚝 이미지 for you? To you? 굴뚝 하면 어떤 느낌이 들어요? What do you think about if you think about the image of 굴뚝? 아, maybe this smoke part I'm gonna delete it. So or I can actually draw another 굴뚝. Like some 굴뚝 is very like huge, big, like that, right? For smoke is not related to this 굴뚝. When you see the 굴뚝, 어떤 느낌이 들어요? 안녕. 비덜립 씨 오랜만이에요. 얼마나 이거 조금 어렵죠? I actually picked this one and I kind of 뭐라고 학생들이 대답할까? I was curious about how you guys answer this quiz. 아, actually it's not bad. Like okay, if you see the 굴뚝 chimney, it's high. But also kinda. 와, are you saying the mind is empty? That's a kind of cool. 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 그럼 if I'm saying, 나 마음이 굴뚝 같아. I'm going to give you a great hint. 나 장미 선생님, 한국어 수업을 보고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아. 타임존이, so my time zone is, I cannot see her live streaming because my time zone. But I, 방송을 보고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. 올리비아 씨, 안녕하세요. She actually giving you guys a perfect example. 술 먹고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 지호 씨, 딩동댕동. So your desire are, 그러니까 you really wanna do something. That is not quite you expected. Yes, but 굴뚝이라고 하면 정말 튼튼하고 something steady and something big and like 그런 느낌 때문에 온것 같아요. I'm just guessing. But 마음이 굴뚝 같다. That 나 지금 it's like midnight now, but I wanna eat 라면 so badly, but I can't. 근데 라면 먹고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아. I really wanna have that 라면. 그럴 때 쓰는 한국어 표현이에요. So this is a Korean expression. 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 좋아. 어려웠죠? 미안해요. I start with something hard. Sorry about that, guys. But at least I hope you guys learn the word 마음, 아이고, 오, 마음 and 굴뚝. So 마음 is mind, heart. 굴뚝 is chimney. 라면 먹지 마. 오케이, 넘어갈게요. Let's move on to the next. Next is also quiz. I love quiz so much. I don't know, you guys, do you guys know about some Korean 속담? You know what is 속담, guys? 속담이 뭐예요? 왜 지워지지가 않지? 속담. The answer? That you want something badly, I guess. You desire something 엄청나게 간절히 원한다. 이런 뜻이에요. You want something badly. 그런 거? 네, I saved the note to KTC. Thank you for remind me. Next, we are going to learn the 속담. 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. 그럴 어떨 때쓸수 있냐면 아침 씨, if you want to miss someone bad, so much. 만나고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. 오늘 한국 가고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. Nowadays, I really, really want to visit Korea. 한국 가고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. 한국어 배우고 싶은 마음이 굴뚝 같아요. 굴뚝, not 꿀뚝. 꿀 is honey. 굴. 자, next. This is quiz. 너무 어렵죠? But I'm going to drawing hint too. 'You're also going to learn the word from this.' 아, 이렇게 그리면 안 되나? 맞나? 이렇게 그리면 안 되나? 그리고 힌트. 벌써 누가 왠지 지금 채팅이 막 올라가고 있는데 내가 지금 나중에 볼게요. 왜냐면 벌써 왠지 답이 나왔을 것 같다. I kind of sense that you guys already got the answer. 오케이. 한국어 배우기 꿀잼이에요. 나이스. Writing in red? 예. 맞네. 미안. 강아지? 강아지도 뭐. 와, 모르다. 오. 리우 후아니스트시. 딩동댕동. 벌써 맞췄어. Not. Not이 영어로 뭐야? Oh, I actually don't know. What is not in English? 그풀 베는 데 쓰는 거 있잖아요. For get rid of the 시클. 시클 맞는데? 시클. Not. 발음하는 것도 알려줄게요. Not. So pronunciation, not is not. 네, not. 그래서 이렇게 풀이 이렇게 쇽쇽쇽쇽 풀 자르는 거. 영어로 시크. not. 코. 기역. Guys, you know what is this, right? 기역. 토. 모른다. Not 놓기. 놓다. 놓다 is put. 놓고 the dictionary form is 놓다. 놓다 means put. 난 놓고 기역자도 모른다. 무슨 뜻일까요? Guys, can you guess the meaning? So you need to see that this thing. Not sick. If you see the sick from now on, from today, you will remember the 기역. 기역 is first consonant of 한글. 기역. 가나다라 마바사. 기역 is first consonant of 한글. 기역. 와우, 아미가몽 씨. 오. Anyone can guess the meaning of this? 아니에요, 아미가몽 씨. 기역자. 자 is from like 글자, so 기역 글자, 기역 letter. So letter라고 하면 안 되지 사실. letter는 consonant랑 vowel랑 합쳐서 letter고. 어쨌든. 아, alphabet. Yes. Korean alphabet. 기역. The first consonant of Korean alphabet. Yes. 맞아요. 기역. 여러분. 맞아, 이카로스 씨. Yes. The firekeeper 씨. Literally translated is correct. Putting down a sickle and not even knowing the shape of 기역. 아니야, 아니, 아닌데. So 모른다 means don't know. Not knowing. 모르다. 모르다. 두 not know라고 써야지 정확하려나? 모르다 is to not know. 나 투, 나 노. 몰라. 넘어갈게. Hello, Rachel 씨. 오케이. 난 놓고 기억자도 모른다. So it means, you know, if you see the sickle, the shape, it looks like 기역, right? The shape of sickle is looks like 기역. Then you think about it, like you see the sickle, and then if the teacher come to you, what is 기역 looks like? I'm asking you, what is 기역 looks like? And you actually see the sickle in front of you, which is exactly same as shape of 기역, right? But you don't know. So, 난 놓고 기억자도 모른다라는 것은 무슨 뜻이냐면, you're that dumb. someone who are not smart. So even there is like in front of you, in front of this person, exactly giving your answer though they don't know about that. That's the 난 놓고 기억자도 모른다. 그래서 if you met someone and he's kinda don't understand easily or 난 놓고 기억자도 모른다는 is a person that not that smart or actually dumb. 그렇게 해야 돼요. 더 파이어키퍼스랑 네이토 씨가 알았어? 오. 그리고 Don't know where to put my secret. 아, 아니, 아니. 어? 오케이. 안녕, 진아. I miss the thing. 아, 모르겠어요. 미안해요. 내가 글씨 쓰느라고 채팅을 못 읽었네. So, first, you will learn the word which is not, sickle, and not you pronounce as not and 기역. So the Korean alphabet, first consonant of Korean alphabet, we call this one as 기역. And 모른다 is 몰라요. 선생님, I don't know, 몰라요. So the 모르다 is the dictionary form is 모르다, which means I don't know. Not knowing. And I'm going to read this chat after the stream to understand what you guys are talking about now. I cannot read every chat right now, but anyway, guys, 좋아. 이것도 save. 아, 이거 근데 그것도 써주자. 아까 누가 트랜슬레이트, 리터럴리 트랜슬레이트 되게 잘해준 사람이 있었는데? Can you give us some example, 로쌤? 뭐가 있을까? 뭐가 있을까요? 이걸 많이 쓰는데, 잠깐만. 지금 잠깐 제가 약간 지금 좀 정신이 없어요. 저 사람은 너무 무식해서 난 놓고 기억자도 모르는 사람이야. But that guys are so dumb. He doesn't even know. 그러니까 그렇게 써요. 저 사람 너무 무식해서 난 놓고 기억자도 모르는 사람이야. 이렇게 써요. So that guy is so dumb. He doesn't 그런 식으로. 아이고, 네. 지금 이 마이크의 문제는 it got all sound from everywhere, and my husband's sitting that next to me. They hear the sound of PlayStation. 뭐라고? 네, 그렇습니다. 좋아요. 오늘 좀 너무 어렵게 갔죠? I start with too hard, right? Sorry about that, guys. 땅. 근데 다음에는 토픽 단어 갑니다, 여러분. 아, 낫이 니은자 같았어요? 근데 낫을 근데 이렇게 놓진 않잖아요. You don't put the knot like this. Not if you think about knot, that is looks like this, right? Isn't it? It's just me thinking about that way. Okay. Topic. So, if you guys come to our Discord channel, I share the link of this list of topic word. You can download it and study yourself. So, 토픽 이렇게 쓰는 거 아닌데? 토픽, Korean, 토픽. So 한국어 능력 시험 초급 단어. 오늘 아까 속담이랑 이디엄이랑 어려웠으니까 오늘 지금 조금 쉬운 걸로. I'm gonna pick the random 10 Korean words and you guys will. Oh my god, it's so hard to draw though. What? 어렵다, 씨. 아니, 이거, it's kind of also challenge to me. I need to draw. So. 이렇게 띠르르. 자, 문제. What is this? 이게 뭐예요? 이게 뭐예요, 여러분? Can you guys guess what this word? So this is a word from the topic of basic in basic Korean word. 아마다시 안녕하세요. 바지. But it's a three syllables. 아미가방 씨, if you are intermediate, so when I actually quiz the basic word. 오케이. 반 바지. 피오나 씨. 올. 굿잡. So the word is 옷. 반 바지. So guys, you already know 바지 is pants, right? But the short pants is 반바지. Okay. Guys, if you're When I say it's an intermediate word, intermediate student, please join the quiz. But if I say it's a basic word, then. 반 means half. 맞아요. Good. 반 means half. Or 반 also kind, I kind of feel like I didn't really search for it. 근데 우리 반말이라는 것도 있잖아요, 한국어에. 반말. So there is just 말 and 반말. So I think 반 also have a meaning of like short, half. 그런 뜻이 있는 것 같아요. 그죠? What do you think? 찾아볼까? 아니야, 아니야. I don't have a time. I only have 30 minutes left, guys. So 반 means half. 오렌지 반바지, 나이트, 굿짜. 근데 오렌지가 한국어로 뭐지? What is orange in Korean? 오렌지. 오렌지가 오렌지 컬러, since 오렌지 컬러. What is 오렌지 컬러? 오, 피오나 씨 so close. 맞아. 주. 화, 지호씨, 딩동댕동, 주황색. 맞아요. 오케이. 이것도 save. next one. next one은, 우리 지금 인터미디엇이 많으니까 인터미디엇을 하나 픽합니다. 아, 그림 지우지 말걸. Actually, that word, the next word, I can use this one again. So let me just delete that this part. So you guys need to guess what I am drawing here. 사실 어떻게 그려야 되는지 잘 모르겠어요. 이게 뭘까요, 여러분? This is intermediate level. Intermediate level. Now, yes, 아미가 방식 not correct. Yes, it's bad, but Korean word. 네, so people use this word as a belt, even Korean, native Korean. But 벨트매 이렇게 얘기하지만 there is actually Korean word for it. 한국말로 모르는데요. 뭘까요? 근데 think about it. Where you put this? 어디에 매요? Where do you wear it? 어디에? 와, 근데 너무 지금 다들 맞추고 있는데 타이포가 있어요. 다들 There's no one actually type in without typo. There's no perfect answer yet. Guys, try. 아미가 역시 딩동댕동. 네, 허리. 띠. So guys, 허리 means waist. 여기가 허리잖아요. So it's part of human body. Waist. Waist 스펠링 모르는데. 이거 할까? A. W이야? WA야? WA야? 맞다, 맞다, 맞다. 허리 맞아요? Waist. T는 그러니까 끈 같은 걸 T라고 해요. So T is like a T를 뭐라고 하죠? T is belt. Band, belt. Band, belt. 이런 걸 T라고 하네요. T is band. So 머리띠 is a hair band. 허리띠 is belt. So 머리띠 있잖아요. The hair band. We call it 머리띠. 머리띠. T can be so if it's woman like this. 아. it looks like kind of male. But 어떻게 하면 여자처럼 할수 있을까? Okay. So You know, woman wears a hairband like this. Oh, terrible. Okay. So, this one we call 머리띠. So,띠 means belt or band. So, 머리띠 means hairband. 초커? I agree with you. 초커는 목띠라고 할수 있겠지만 초커로 그냥 초커라고 하더라고요. 목띠 괜찮은데? 예쁜 목띠. 좋아. 하나만 더 갈까? Random word. It's for beginners. Okay. 근데 이거 인터미디엇 학생들도 모를 수도 있겠다. 먼저 이걸 알려줄게요. 초성. So, 쌍시옷. 쌍시옷. So, it's like, 약간 이런 느낌인데, guys, like 이런 느낌이에요. So, 네, Actually, the word is for the topic word. It's in a beginner word list, but I feel like maybe intermediate guys, you don't know about this word too. So that's why I think it's something between beginners and intermediate, it's in a beginners. 심심하다. 피오나씨, 딩동댕동 맞았어요. 쌀쌀하다. 쌀쌀하다. So, guys, can you guess the meaning of the 쌀쌀하다 from this image? 톡식, 안녕. 쌀쌀하다, 어떤 뜻이에요? 아, 아니요. 쌀쌀해. Chilly. Yes, 맞아요. 춥다랑은 조금 달라요. 춥다 is you feel cold. But 쌀쌀하다 is the weather for something between fall and winter. Like, it's not really winter. 근데, 그러니까 춥다보다는 덜 추워. So it's, I would like to say it's like more chilly. Yes, 맞아요. 아마다시 맞아요. So 쌀쌀하다는 chilly 이런 뜻이에요. 그러면 사실 오늘 Actually, before I do the streaming, I go out for a walk. I thought it's hot today. Today was hot, so I only wear like this and go out. Then the weather actually was 쌀쌀하다 today. 오늘 좀 쌀쌀했어요. 그래서 반팔을 입었는데 조금 I feel chilly. 쌀쌀하다. 쌀쌀하다. 칠리 나 스펠링을 몰라 칠리 오케이 쌀쌀하다 쌀쌀하면 심심해요? Don't confuse with these two words because I actually heard it from 아마다시였나? When you guys study Korean, sometimes Korean books they mention the sound similar The word sound similar, but totally not relative. But then, if you actually study those words at the same time, your brain just got it all in a confused way. So maybe someday you kind of messed up. Like when you want to say, "Oh, I'm so bored." 그러니까 나 심심해라고 얘기를 해야 될 때, 아, 나 쌀쌀해 이렇게 얘기할 수도 있는 거예요. Like you know what I mean? So that I think it's quite a nice to learn the word that are also similar. The sounds kind of similar, so you actually learn more words. But then later you may it's all like mixed up in your brain, and then you're using in a very wrong way. So 약간 걱정되지만 still I think it's good. 쌀쌀하다? 여기도 쌀쌀해요. 지호보식 잘했어요. Good job. 쌀쌀하다. 아, 좋아, 좋아. 여러분, so far so good? Did you guys learn something? Or am I too fast? Or are you having fun? Or are you watching my streaming now and study, but don't really engage in the chat? But if you're still there, please type one. So I see your ID. So this is time for spam. Number one. Even your work lurker, I wanna see if you're there or not. Wow, 럴커 엄청 많네. 진짜. I didn't know. I have. 아이고. 네, I also agree with you, Natos. Even I'm Korean native, but learn proverbs is kind of fun. It's like for me, it's very, very short
You
story.
can swallow yourself.
You know, 방금, can you guys hear the sound? I have a Google speaker at home. What was the her name? 여보, 저 구글 저 스피커 이름이 뭐죠? Anyway, that thing heard my voice and suddenly she talked to me that you are so sweet. Why? Understand? The speaker just say to me, "You are so sweet," from nowhere. 아, 너무 웃기다. 네. 어쨌든, 오케이. Guys, 좋다고? 그럼 계속 갑시다. So far we learn 마음이 굴뚝 같다. I want something so. 마음이 굴뚝 같다. I want something so badly. Badly 말고 무슨 단어가 지금 제 영어가 딱 단어가 떠올. 너무너무 간절히 원하는 걸 얘기할 때 마음이 굴뚝 같다. 이렇게 얘기하고. Number two. 우리가 뭐 배웠지? 낯 놓고 기억자도 모른다. So when you actually describe someone very dumb, not smart, we say 저 사람은 낯 놓고 기억자도 모르는 사람이야. That person is like 낯 놓고 기억자도 모른다. 그리고 우리가 또 랜덤 토픽 워드를 배웠죠? First word was a 반바지, which is a short. And number two was 허리띠, which is belt. We also learned a 머리띠, which is hairband. And last word was 쌀쌀하다. 아, 쌀쌀해요. 아, earning이라고 해? 목띠는 아니야, 아니야. Don't be, 목띠 사용하지 말아요. If you say 목띠, I don't know how many Korean, native Korean understand right away. 아, 목띠 이거지? 이라고. 모르겠네. 오케이. Okay. 그러면 아, next one. We are going to learn a Korean slang. Korean slang time. So 유행어를 배워볼게요. 유행어, like 유행어. So people are using it a lot this day, but it's not on dictionary. So you may not find the meaning. So can you guys the meaning of this? If you already know, just. But if you don't, if you first time see this word and want to guess the meaning of it, please try.
I think if you watch some Korean TV show these days, I'm 100% you heard about this before. 유행어. 그러니까 유행어, 그러니까 슬랭을 I found a slang on dictionary, English dictionary. Then it says also slang. 그 속어라고 할 수 있기도 하죠. 네, 맞아요. Trendy word. 아미가 막시 맞아요. 근데 it's not on the dictionary. That's why I call this word as a slang. 맞아, 맞아. 맞아, 맞아. 어? Trending slang. 이거 알아요? Oh, nice. 그럼 guys, please guess this word. 읽어줄게요. 댕댕이. 댕댕이. This word sounds like 댕댕이. 댕댕이. 댕댕이가 뭘까요? 댕댕이. 댕댕이. 사실 요거 I don't like the romanization, but if I would like to say 댕댕이. 아니 이거 당당이로 보이려나? 이렇게 써야 되나? 댕댕이. 댕댕이. Play hockey? Why suddenly it's play hockey? 댕댕이. 댕댕이. Since, Beatrice, you already know it, right? No? You guessed it? Okay. 댕댕이 means puppy. Then, 네, 그럼요. You can, I think, since Beatrice already mentioned it, puppy? 몰라. 댕댕이 is a puppy. Puppy, 댕댕이. 내가 댕댕이 그려줄게. 아, 너무 귀엽다. This picture. So cute. I wanna draw it. So guys, while I'm drawing, you guys can explain why 댕댕이 is puppy. Please do that. Free Keepers랑 Beatrice, why 댕댕이 is puppy? And please explain to the other student. And while you guys doing it, I'm gonna just draw this guy. So cute. 너무 귀여워. 너무너무 귀여워. 너무너무 귀여워. When you feel down, just go to the Reddit owl and just see some like cute animal that heals you. 아, 너무 좋아. 오늘 산책하다가 고양이 봤어요, 저 사실. I met a cat while I walk today. 어, I don't have a space. He doesn't look like a puppy. He more looks like a 다 큰 강아지. 개처럼 보이는데. 에이, 못 그리겠다. 에이, 몰라 몰라. I don't have a time, right? Okay. 따단. 네. 그래서 the reason 이게 뭐니? 너무 못 그렸다. So bad. 댕댕이. 여러분, 멍멍이 is puppy. In Korean word, 멍멍이. It's also kind of slang. 강아지. So there's so many way to say puppy in Korea, which is 강아지. But 멍멍이 is the when people want to call the 강아지 more cuter, we call 멍멍이. So I think dictionary form of puppy is 강아지. 멍멍이, I'm not sure it is on a dictionary, but I think 멍멍이 is also kind of slang. So it's a 멍멍이 is cute way to say 강아지, puppy. And how 멍멍이 changed to the 댕댕이? As you can see here, Korean people are so creative. This looks like 댕댕이. You need to follow what I type. 뭐야? What? 댕. 댕. 이. So, 멍. Also looks like very similar shape of 댕. Are you agree with this? 멍. 헐. 아마단 땡땡땡. 네. So the Korean letter 멍. Very the just look shape of the letter 멍 very similar to the 댕. 멍 댕. So people say 댕댕이. 어, 맞아. Another one is 커엽다. 아 진짜? It was difficult to guess? 맞아요. 왜냐하면 this one actually I got it from the Korean school. We do a teacher seminar and between the seminar we did some kind of recreation and then we had a Korean slang quiz time. Like, and I didn't guess at the first time. I thought, what is 댕댕이? What does 댕댕이 means? It was a quiz and I need to get it. We actually had a prize for it. So, 아 뭐지? 뭐지? 막 생각했는데 댕댕이 was 멍멍이었어요. So I learned it from them. But anyway, 댕댕이란 말 요즘 뭐 너무 많이 써요. 그러니까 if you googling it, the 댕댕이, I'm 100% sure you will see lots of people using a 댕댕이. If you're using SNS, like Instagram or Twitter, just type 댕댕이, then you will see lots of puppy picture. 댕댕이 사진 많이 보세요. And I totally failed to draw 댕댕이. So sad. So sad. So sad. 슬퍼요. 오늘 그림 못 그렸어. 시간이 없으니까 마음이 급해요. Since I don't have enough time, I kinda 잘 그리고 싶었는데. 댕댕이. 멍멍이. 그냥 엉망이 그려야지 이렇게. So this is 멍멍이. 그냥 이렇게 그릴게요. 멍멍이입니다. 네, 이거는 다음에 커엽다는 내일 할게. I'm gonna explain why 커엽다. What does 커엽다 means? 커엽다. Tomorrow. 아휴. So 댕댕이 is the word you learned today. 아 이것도 save, save. Don't forget to save. Don't forget to save. And last one is for more like 조금 어려울 수도 있지만 it's really good to know 사자성어. So 사자성어 is from 한자, China, I guess. So it's a four-letter word, and each letter has a meaning. So the four letter has their own story about it. So today we are going to learn 다산지. And then the reason why I'm teaching you guys 사자성어 because if you're watching Korean TV show, the 자막, the subtitle or effect, they're using 사자성어 a lot. If I'm 100% sure, if I type 사전, if I watch Korea entertainment show, and at least I can find one 사자성어 on the screen. So actually, I screen capture a lot to share others my student. That so first Korean use 사자성어 a lot. Not really in a conversation, but in the book, on the book or on the screen, on the TV show, we are using it a lot. And then the second reason why I'm teaching you guys this 사자성어, since each letter is 한자, so if you know. For example, if you know the 타, which means 다르다. The 타 means 다르다. which means different. If you know this word, then if you see some word like 타인, 무슨 뜻일까요? In means 사람, human. So if you see the 타인, that means different person, other person, 이런 뜻이에요. 타인 means other people, another people, other people. Other person? 이런 식으로 if you know some 한자, you can guess the new word easily. So, each. So think about it, the in English word, some English word is from Latin or French. For example, aqua. Aqua means water. So, you know, there's like long letter. 뭐 무슨 말 있을까? 아쿠아가 들어가는 영어 긴 단어 혹시 아는 거 있어요? Guys, do you guys know about any English word vocabulary include aqua? Aqua something something something. Aquatic. Aqua aerobic. So if I see that word, but if I know the word aqua, I can guess at least it's just something related to the water, right? So that's the same thing. If you know some 한자, some 한자, then you see some new word, you have no idea what is 타인. But if you know the 타 means 다르다, you can guess, 아, 이거 something 타인? 다르다? 이런 게 있어요. Aquamarine. Aquaman. Yeah, Aquaman. Think about it. If I saw Aquaman, then I just can see, it's just something, the man who living in, you know, under the water or something like that. 그런 거예요. So, 그래서, that reason, that's why I'm teaching you guys this part. You may think it's too hard, but it's just good to know. So, and if you're an intermediate level Korean student, you also need to study 사자성어, even topic. 토픽에서도 써요. 토픽에서도 나오고 하니까 공부하면 좋을 거예요. That's the reason why I'm teaching you guys this. And that's the 그러니까 사자성어, and this is actually more like 한자 수업이에요. 산! 여러분 산 뭔지 알죠? 산 is 산. 산 is mountain. 산 is mountain. 이거 산 같지가 않네. 산 is mountain. 지는요, 사실 이게 한자로 그냥 약간 전치사 같은 거예요. It's like preposition. So it means of. So this word, it's not that important. You don't need to know. And 석. 석 means I'm gonna draw. 석 is like something like 석 뜻. 이게 뭐야? It looks like garbage. 아이야. 못 그리겠다. 비틀리스 딩동댕동. It means rock. So 타산지석. It literally means is rock from the another mountain. So, rock of another mountain. 그런 뜻이에요. 안녕하세요. So, it has a background story. So, you know, even the other mountain of rock, you feel like it's not important to you or it doesn't really matter to you. But you can actually use that rock that shape your with that rock, you can you use the rock to shape the precious diamond or something like that. 네, 맞아요. 그래서 오브라고 썼어요. 지. 으. 맞아요. 한국어로 으. 아, 맞아. 으, 한국어로 안 썼네. 오, 아마다시 나이스. 으의 으라는 뜻이에요. 네. 그래서 그런 뜻이에요. 그래서 타산지석의 뜻은 the meaning of the 타산지석 then you can learn something from others for others foolish 라는 뜻이에요. So rock is actually considering it as a useless or like something not important or more like here it means like useless. But you can learn something from the other people foolish 그런 뜻이에요. 그런 영어 있잖아요. Learn from others' mistake. 아무 이 가방씨 정답. 딩동댕동. I found this one in English translate today because I have an episode about this. That's why it just came to my mind. But if I talking about that episode, it will take another few minutes and our actually lesson is done. So 그래서 타산지석이라는 말은 정말 많이 써요. 그러니까 만약에 다른 사람이 뭔가 실수한 걸 보고 you learn a lot from that mistake. 타산지석을 교훈 삼아. 그러니까 뭐 예를 들어서 이런 코로나 situation we see some country actually deal with it very well but some country not very well. Then we actually see that their mistake and then we do in different way. We need to wear the mask or we need to wash hands and the government giving you guys, giving you the people a very clear direction. So we actually learn from the other country mistake. You know what I mean? So 타산지석을 그때 써요. You can use that 타산지석 in that case. You learn from the other's mistake. 아, 이것도 remember the save note. I actually did not save everything today. So I'm going to share upload it on our Discord channel, the teacher's note, our Discord server, and you see the teacher's note channel. But not sure. 빠빡. 네. 오늘도 수업이 끝났습니다. 오, 나 몇 분 했지? 1 hour. Yay! Exact 1 hour. So guys, 아유 감사합니다. Guys, thank you. 아이수 씨 안녕. 왜 뷰티풀 수업이 뭐야? 아, 미국. 아 그러면 since 아이수 씨 you just say the soup word, I wanna say 여러분 이거 어떻게 읽어요? 숲, right? 아 숲. 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 What 내가 만약에 여러분한테 숲, 숲 이렇게 말하면 what you guys in your mind in English word 숲, 숲 in English word is it sound same 숲, 숲 아니야 숲, 숲, 숲 그치 줄리 씨 you guys can heard like 숲 English word but the 숲 actually the meaning is forest. And why I brought it up? Because I just say soup. 근데 soup in Korea actually it is 국에 가깝나? 찌개? Something between 국 and 찌개 or also people say soup. So soup can be soup and 국 and 찌개. Forest 하나만 써? 오, 예. 오, 쪽팔려. 오, what a shame. I'm so good spelling, guys. 고맙습니다. 어? 또 무슨 얘기했어? So, guys. I'm going to do a 30 days Korean lesson challenge and you guys doing a 30 days learn Korean challenge, study Korean challenge. So I'm from today, I'm going to do the streaming every day. I'm going to You can check our Twitch channel. You see the schedule tab and you will see the schedule. So tomorrow, I didn't upload it yet, but tomorrow, same time tomorrow, I'm gonna do another streaming. So I'm going to do streaming every day, 1 hour a day. So it's going to be really challenging for me, and I'm sure it's also very challenging for you guys. So, but let's do it. Only for a month. 한 달 동안. 같이 합시다. And thank you for... Except someday, right? Yeah, Gio 씨, 사실 제가 좀 걱정했어요. I kind of worry about it. Should I... do you think I don't trust myself. So I don't have a, like 100% confidence. 근데 if I actually miss the Sunday, it's not going to be challenging then, right? So for me, it's a 30 days Korean lesson challenge. And if you guys just come to and then participate just like today, I strongly feel like I can do that. And sorry about that I missed some chatting today. I'm gonna read it after the streaming. Promise. 약속할게요. 채팅 볼게요. 그리고 감사합니다. 이카루스 씨. 그리고 guys. ISC 씨 도와주세요. Help me. 마음대로 하세요? 아, 나한테 선 게 아니군요. 그래서 너무너무 고맙고 오늘도 재밌었어요. I had a lot of fun with you guys. I hope you guys have fun too. And I hope to see you guys tomorrow. 그러면 3. 아, 그리고 여러분 next week stay tuned because 하나쌤 will go to PC방. But we don't know the exact time yet. So just stay tuned. I love the in real life streaming in Korea with 하나쌤. 안녕, 삼. So, what about if I say 1, you also type 1 with me? 삼, 2, 1. 안녕. 와, 와, 오 마이 갓. 오 마이 갓, 안녕. Spam, I love spam so much. Ooh. 안녕.